home. God bless you. Ooh. It doesn't take any effort. If you truly know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, it doesn't take much to take you into that spiritual realm. And you have to catch yourself. It can uplift you, and you will be in a zone. And in that zone, in that atmosphere, at that level of praise, you don't even want to come out of it. Well, God bless you. I'm not going to be before you long because it's kind of late. I'm not going to be before you long. I wanted to come in and talk for a few minutes out of Mark chapter 16. Again, my name is Dr. Earlene Harris. I was doing a little straightening up, and a commercial, advertisement, whatever you want to call it, came on television, and they were advertising a new show that's coming on, and I can't remember the name of the show, but it was talking about how couples are going from being inmates to roommates. And it kind of bothered me because I felt like, once again, here, the world is glamorizing all the negative things in society. They're glamorizing this kind of stuff. And our young people are watching this. And I said to myself, why is the world publicizing making things that are not seemly seem so seemly, making it look good? And I thought to myself, why are there not more shows to glamorize and to emphasize and to uplift the Christian walk? Jesus and the Bible and the Gospel and the Holy Spirit and God the Father. And God said to me,
it's
not the world's job to bring knowledge of me. It's your job to bring knowledge of me. It's the people that I have called and chosen, the preachers, the ministers, the Christians, is their job to be, thank you, Holy Spirit, to be counterintuitive, to strategize, just like they're strategizing to make everything that they endeavor to make their platforms popular. You in turn have to strategize to make the Word of God pliable, Holy Spirit, pliable and accessible, and make it not seem like it's so hard for people of the world to accomplish this lifestyle. It's not the world's job, Erlene, to glorify me. It's your job. And when he said that to me, of course I was convicted, because I don't think I've ever been as gung-ho as I wanted to be in this walk, in my calling, in my chosen status as a minister of the gospel. And I know it's us, and it could, maybe it's the enemy that wants to condemn us because sometimes we feel like we're inadequate. Man, I'm not doing enough. I'm not talking enough. I'm not going before God's people enough. I'm not sharing the gospel enough. I'm not letting the other day about letting our light shine and not hiding our light under a bushel or a basket. Am I letting my light shine? Am I glamorizing? Am I glorifying? Am I advertising? Am I making, thank you, Holy Spirit, am I making a strategic move toward the goal to raise up the name of Jesus Christ in this world? Are they winning? Is it a battle? The Bible teaches us, Holy Spirit, the Bible teaches us that there is a war between good and evil. We have to take our position. No, the world will not win. God has already won when he sent his son Jesus the Christ down the cross for our sins. The battle has already been won. But we, as chosen men and women of God, we have to stay on the front line. We have to stay strategically placed. As if, you see movies where, in the military, where different naval commanders and different officers, they all stand around the table, and there's a map. A huge map laid out on the table, and they're talking, discussing strategies on how to approach and how to win missions and campaigns that that they have encountered. Let me read this. Father God, I thank you right now. We thank you, Lord, for this time. We thank you, Father God, for teaching. We thank you, Father God, for loving us. We thank you, Father God, for being patient with us. Father God, let me decrease and you increase as I go before your people and say, "But thus saith the Lord." In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I speak right now deliverance, blessings, hallelujah, by your hand. And by your might and by your power. In the name of Jesus the Christ, I pray. Amen. Hold on a minute. Mark, let's read this right quick. Mark chapter 16, verses 15 through, I think, 15 to 20, I want to say. 15 to 20. Yeah. Still believe in God for clear vision. In the meantime, we're going to make it do what it do. He said to them, Go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up snakes with their hands. And when they drink deadly poison, my God, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people, and they will get well. Verse 19, after the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven, and he sat at the right hand of God. Then the disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by the signs that accompanied it. Okay. Jesus' work is already done. His campaign is already finished. And the Bible teaches us that he ascended into heaven and he sits at the right hand of the Father. His work is complete. So he left everything to us. Now we must do our part. He tells us to go into all the world and preach the gospel. And now he's made it even so easy. We don't even have to travel unless we have engagements. We don't even have to travel unless we are a pastor of a set and saved a ministry, a building. We can be right in the comfort of our own homes and get on this worldwide web, this internet, and preach the gospel to millions and millions of people. Go into all the world. It's our time. It's our turn. As children of God, as soldiers of the ministry, as champions, hallelujah, as champions of the ministry, it is our job now to do our part. It's time to do our part. We have to finish. Jesus has already finished it now. But we have to keep talking about it. Keep teaching about it. We have to let the world know. We have to let the world know more than ever before. While the world is doing their part, while the world is being the world, while the world is glamorizing everything that is unseemly, and they're not glamorizing of the word of God on these different apps, on these TV shows, on these different channels. Now they're glamorizing almost anything that's disgusting. Even this show now, and I never watched it, I never will. Yes, I was a nurse from 1991, excuse me. From 1991 to 2018. I've seen it all, I've done it all, and I've cleaned it all. But I'm not going to sit in my house and watch some woman, I don't know if she's a doctor or what, but they call her Dr. Pimple Popper. I'm not going to sit in my house and watch that woman bust pimples and bust pulse-filled bumps. Bestials is what we call it. People glamorize all. I mean, the world is glamorizing all kinds of mess. We have to work harder and harder in our campaigns. What office, what position that God has called us to be in, we have to go at it harder now, more than ever before, because the world has taken the focus The world has taken the focus off of what's important. And Lord, when COVID-19 showed up on the scene, that's all some of us needed. COVID-19 is gone about its business. It's gone on. And this church buildings are still empty. My niece said it best. She said it's empty. It's so empty in some of these sanctuaries. She said you could, Elder Belinda Rice, she said you could throw a rock in the building and not hit nobody. What was she saying? She's saying that the churches are empty. These big, beautiful churches that are being built, that have been built, or that are new, practically empty. But have a concert for Beyonce. Have an R&B concert. Have a football, your favorite football team play. Or go to some of these spring break destinations. Or even these cruises. Oh my God. When I saw how many people, but you're worried about catching something in the church. When I saw how compact, how many people are allowed to be on these cruise ships. I mean, they were packed in there like sardines. When I saw how many people are on these cruise ships, some of these cruise ships, I said, no ma'am, no sir, thank you, but I'm good. They're okay with packing out things for pleasure, for recreation, but when it comes to Christian, when it comes to Christ, when it comes to serving God, we have excuses. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm going to say today. That's all I'm going to say this evening. I pray that something has been said that will bless you and that will encourage you. And if God has called you into position, even if you don't have a title, if you have been baptized and Holy Ghost filled, you still have a commission to fill. You still have an assignment. You still have a campaign to tell, and you have a charge to tell somebody. You know what? Let me tell you about a man. Mm-hmm. Let me share something with you. And 9 times out of 10, even if you approach somebody at the mall and they're total strangers, they're going to stop and listen. Because God, the Bible teaches us that we do of the planting, God does the harvest. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to stop there. I pray once again that something I've said has blessed you and encouraged you to keep on moving forward in your ministry. Mm-hmm. Father God, we thank you for this time. We thank you for this fellowship. And prick our hearts. Convict us, Father God. If we become stale, if we become comfortable, too comfortable in not doing what we were called to do, prick and convict our hearts, Father God, so that we may awaken with a fresh anointing, with a renewed vigor to preach the gospel. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. And if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, let me extend on this evening this invitation to say, Father God, forgive me of my sins. I believe you sent your Son Jesus Christ to die on the cross for my sins. And I want you to come into my life and come into my heart. That's it. That's it. That's all. Find you a good Bible-based church Give your right hand to the preacher and give your heart to God. We say to you right now, welcome. Welcome to the kingdom of heaven. God bless you. God keep you is my prayer. Have a wonderful evening, and I will see you guys again tomorrow.